Good day, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Favi, and welcome to Arrow's DIY. On my channel, I like to do Dollar Tree DIYs, high-end dupes, as well as thrift flips. Today, I'm going to be showing you 5 DIYs that might give you ideas for your fall tier tray. These ideas are super easy to do, and they're made from Dollar Tree items. I hope you enjoy, so let's get started. For DIY number 1, we're going to be using this berry garland I got at the Dollar Tree. We're going to take a ruler and measure about 11 inches. Take the first 8 inches and you're going to make a loop. We're going to twist the end of the loop, making sure to leave that about 2 to 3 inches at the end. This is important for securing our pumpkin. Now we're going to go ahead and rotate and make another loop on the other side of the pumpkin. Every time we arrive at the same place we started, we're going to go ahead and twist that 2-inch piece around to secure it in place. You're going to have to hold the other end with your hand and continue the same process. I go around 8 times to make my orb shape, but you can go as many times as you'd like. Once you have all the revolutions that you want in your pumpkin, you're going to go ahead and hold that centerpiece in place as you space out the wire as equally as possible. Once you have it spaced out equally, you're going to take another piece of garland about 5 inches, and you're just going to secure the other side like so. Just wrap it around in between the wires so that everything is secure. Once you like the shape that it gives you, go ahead and press the center down and make a nice plump pumpkin. Now we're going to make the stem, and I just used the garland. You can make a stem out of anything you'd like. I wanted my stem to be about 1 inch in length, so I just wrapped it around like so. Once I went around about 10 times, I cut it with a tail of about 5 inches. Now I'm going to put the tail through the loop and wrap it around about 1.5 times, leaving another end so that I could secure it to the pumpkin. Now I just take the little tail and put it under one of the wires of our pumpkin, and then we're going to just wrap it around in place. So I know this is not a traditional pumpkin, but I like making unique DIYs on my channel. So if this is something that might interest you, you might want to hit the subscribe button. Now I could have left it here, but on my channel I like to take it a bit further. If you're new here, welcome. And if you're not new, you know I always like to add a little something extra to my DIY. So I'm just going to add this little piece of garland. I'm going to hot glue it to the bottom there as well as the center. And this is just going to help add a little interest to our abstract pumpkin shape. Let me know in the comments below if you'd like this DIY. Now for DIY number 2, we're just going to take these pumpkin decor, as Dollar Tree calls it, and it's the 4-pack. They're the smallest pumpkins that I could find at my Dollar Tree. I'm also going to use this garland that my mother was nice enough to give me. I don't know where she got it, but I'm going to guess Michael's. and then I'm just gonna pick off some of those stems. Now I'm gonna use this empty ribbon roll and I'm gonna paint it in this folk art color, winter white. I'm using folk art because it has great coverage. So now I'm just gonna take the remainder of the paint on my brush and just dry brush all of the little pumpkins. It's helpful to hold them by the wire that they come with. So I just pop off those stems and paint it like so. I just didn't want such a strong color in my pumpkins. Now I'm gonna be using this farmer's market calendar for the 2022 Dollar Tree calendars. And I'm gonna be using these two pictures here. I'm gonna cut them out and I'm also gonna offer it as a giveaway to my subscribers. It's the way I show my appreciation today. For all my new subscribers, I just hit 700 subscribers and I'm offering two calendars, the one you see here, as well as this one. This one was offered in another video, but the subscriber never got back to me. So now I'm gonna offer it to any of my other subscribers. I'm gonna take this little picture here from this calendar and I'm gonna Mod Podge it to this ribbon roll. So I'm gonna take this antique matte Mod Podge and I'm just gonna put a nice layer on there. And I'm also going to use this Mod Podge squeegee to help get any wrinkles and extra Mod Podge out from under the little picture. So once I do that, I go ahead and just give a nice layer of Mod Podge to just seal my project. Now I'm gonna put that aside to dry, and while that's drying, I'm gonna cut some twine. The jute twine pieces I cut are about 2 to 3 inches in length, and they're just gonna help me make a knot, so they don't have to be too long. I'm gonna go ahead and take two of this garland pieces we had earlier, and we're just gonna attach them with this twine. I'm attaching the bottom third of one garland to the top third of another garland. Piece of garland. So I go ahead and I secure them with the jute twine and I add a little bit of hot glue and I just give it a double knot. And I do this 5 times. So I attach 5 of these pieces of garland together with the jute twine, with the double knot, and hot glue. Once I have all 5 pieces connected, I go ahead and I connect them to make a circle. I would like to make a wreath form with these greenery. So once it's all connected, I just cut off any excess twine. And now I'm going to use these pumpkins that we painted earlier. Once they're dry, you're going to go ahead and pop the stems back on there. And now we're just going to wrap them around the garland like so. I was very random in the position of these pumpkins. There's really no rhyme, no reason. We're just gonna go ahead and put them all around this wreath. Now, I wanted this to be inspired by the pumpkin patch. I want this to be inspired by a pumpkin patch, so I am just going to put a whole bunch of pumpkins all around this wreath form. I'm just gonna put a whole bunch of pumpkins around this little wreath because this is gonna be the border of my sign, my pumpkin patch sign. Once all the pumpkins are on there and the wires are wound around the wreath, the wreath is now gonna have more structure and we just wanna make sure that the center of the wreath doesn't have any leaves. So we want to try to push and manipulate the greenery so that it's away from the center. And you can do this by just rotating it around the pumpkins and also using jute twine where you think you need it. Now I'm just showing you that this wreath could be put around a candle like this, and it would make a nice candle arrangement. However, I said I was making a sign, so I'm just gonna take that ribbon, that empty ribbon roll, and I'm gonna put the wreath around it. So I just popped off that bottom pumpkin there because it was annoying. But if you like this and videos like this, be sure to hit that thumbs up button because it really helps my channel grow. So now on the other side, I'm gonna put the home calendar piece, and I'm just gonna Mod Podge it like I did on the other side. Now I'm using this berry pick from the Dollar Tree, and I'm just gonna use this to just add a decorative feature around the sign. I just didn't like how that empty space looked around the calendar page, so I'm just gonna use the berry pick. If you don't like the berries, you can also use leaves like I'm doing on the other side. And it just helps and cover that empty space. Again, you don't have to do berries. You can do whatever you like. It's your DIY. I'm not here to tell you what to do. Just trying to share some ideas. And there you have it. This video is part of the Minis Monthly Challenge, and it's hosted by Corie over at Crafted by Corie. She does a lot of farmhouse, beautiful DIYs, some coastal DIYs, as well as Dollar Tree hauls. I'll leave her link to her channel in the description box below, and the playlist link in the description box below as well. So be sure to check out the link. I'll leave it in the description, as well as in the comment section. So now for DIY number 3. We're gonna do this pumpkin. You saw I got the pumpkin pick at Dollar Tree, and I'm just gonna make it hollow in the center there. So I'm using a box blade to cut a circle and cut out that center, because this is gonna be a little planter for our tear tray. I'm gonna take this color by Folk Art One. It's called One, and it's a paint and sealer in one, and in the color called Fresh Earth. I'm gonna give it one rough coat, and now I'm gonna go in with some of that white winter white from Folk Art, and I'm just gonna paint the middle ribs of the pumpkin. Once that's dry, I'm gonna go ahead and give it a second coat in that Fresh Earth color, and this is just gonna help it look like concrete. I wanna give it a faux concrete look. Now I'm gonna take these jewel border stickers from the Dollar Tree, and I'm gonna just cover that center seam there. It kinda had like a line going through the center. And I like it the way it is, but I'm just gonna go and give it another coat of white just to cover that, because although I like the color, I wasn't going for that vibe in this DIY. I'm just gonna go ahead and give it one rough coat, kind of like a dry brushing of this white by Folk Art. And once that's all done, I'm super happy with this, the way it's looking. I'm gonna let it dry, and then I'm gonna add some florals. Now this is the part where you can customize it to your aesthetic or your color scheme. I'm just gonna use these dahlias. It's called Dahlia Bush from the Dollar Tree, and I think these colors are perfect for fall. I take the greenery picks with that center part, and I just put them straight into the foam. It's great that these pumpkins are made out of foam, because it makes it so easy to build this arrangement. You just stick the stems right into the foam. So once I put the greenery in there, I put the florals in, and now I'm just gonna put one of those berry picks. That way our DIYs kind of flow together and they look like they're part of a collection. So once that pick is in there, and a little piece of that greenery as well, I just fix that little leaf there. I kind of make the wire go into an S shape, and now I'm happy with how this is looking. Let me know in the comments below if you like this DIY. Now to be eligible for the calendar, all you gotta do is comment below and be a subscriber, because the giveaway is only for my subscribers. Now for this next DIY, we're gonna take the same pumpkin that It's called Decor at the Dollar Tree. And we're also gonna take these pumpkin clips. And we're gonna just pop that pumpkin off that clip because we only want the pumpkin as well as this little gourd. We're gonna paint the gourd in the same gray color called Fresh Earth by Folk Art Home Decor 1. And we're just going to give it a rough coat in this gray color. Now I'm just using my embossing tool and I just stuck it right in the spot where the pick was. There was already a hole there, so I just stuck it in there and we're gonna paint that. Once that's, we're gonna set it aside to dry. And now we're gonna take this little trophy from the party favor section at the Dollar Tree and we're gonna give it one coat of this gloss black color by Apple Barrel. So I didn't put any Mod Podge on here because I do want this to chip. I want to give this trophy a nice distressed look. So once I give it this coat in this black color, I'm going to distress it with some of this folk art. I'm going to distress it with some antique wax. So I'm also gonna distress this pumpkin as well as the little pumpkin as well, just so everything looks nice and distressed. Kinda like me, distressed. So if you're new to my channel, my name is Favi, hello. And I like to do eclectic home decor on my channel. I like some farmhouse, shabby chic, boho, but I'm very eclectic in my style, so I like doing unique things using Dollar Tree items as well as unexpected items. It's my favorite thing to do on my channel. So if this is something that interests you, you might want to subscribe. I don't know. So now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to dry brush this in white. Now this DIY was inspired by my dear friend MaryBeth over at MBGrayDesigns. I'll leave her link in the description box below. Now, when she did this DIY, she used a crystal candlestick from the Dollar Tree, but I'm just using this little trophy as a planter. And what she did was she made a little topiary for her pumpkin spice challenge. So if you like pumpkins, you'll find a whole bunch more inspiration. I'll link her video in the description box below. So as you can see there, I put some moss first, just to cover that gap at the bottom. Then I added some greenery on top of that. Now I'm gonna put the biggest pumpkin on top of that, and I'm securing it with hot glue. I always use Gorilla hot glue, so that's what I'm using. And it's very, very stable. Now I'm holding my baby at the moment, so don't mind the fact that I'm using one hand, but I really had to get this done because I had no other time to get this done. So then I'm just using the hot glue to secure everything together, and as you can see, I am making kind of a mess. Now I'm trying to take off this little tiny piece of hot glue, like a little string of hot glue there, and I'm dropping my project all over the place. But that's how it turned out. Let me know in the comments below what you think. It's so funny because every time this fell down, my daughter was just cracking up. Because for some reason my kids wanted to be right there with me DIYing. Now this is our last and final DIY. I hope you've enjoyed all these DIYs and I've at least found one idea that inspires you. But for this DIY, we're just gonna use these wood cubes from the Dollar Tree. I cannot find these tumbling tower blocks for the life of me. So I just decided to make a little sign for our tier tray, a double-sided sign using these little wood cubes. So I kind of messed up, so I'm telling you here, don't look at what I'm doing because I did a boo-boo here. I'm supposed to do the square there, it's right. Where I messed up was instead of doing a stack of 5 cubes, I ended up doing a stack of 6 cubes. Now don't do 6 cubes, do the 5 cubes. So what? Two stacks of 7 cubes and 2 stacks of 5 cubes. I hope I'm making sense, but I put it on the in text so that you can see the specifics. Anyways, once that was all straightened out, I wanted to use antique wax for the border of our sign. I'm using the same hot glue. It's a high temperature glue gun, and I'm gonna go ahead and just make that border and stick it on with some hot glue. Now, using this square ruler is very, very, very handy. The problem was that these cubes are not equal. They're not perfectly equal. So you will have to find the perfect cubes to make this, if you want to make this. Or you could use Jenga blocks if you find the tumbly tower blocks. Now I just took the other calendar page and I stuck it on there with the same Mod Podge, the same way I did for the other sign. And now I'm going to take another one of those pumpkins that were on the clips and I'm going to cut it in half just behind where that stem would go, because I want to pop the stem there. Now here I'm putting the stem, but later on my tier tray I ended up putting some berries in there because I thought it was more fun. And you could also stick florals in here. I actually stuck greenery on the other side. And now I'm using this sticker pack and I'm going to take the truck off and then put a big pumpkin on there because that's super fun. And that's how it turned out on my tier tray. So you see I stuck some berries on top there. And I think this is super fun. It's super easy to do. And let me know if you'll give it a try. Leave in the comments what you thought about this. Which one was your favorite DIY today? I appreciate every single one of you and your time. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for subscribing and being awesome. You guys are amazing. So this was another little DIY I made in my last fall tier tray. I'll leave the link in an iCard right here if you guys want to check out that video. And I really hope you enjoyed this video today. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed, I would strongly suggest you subscribe so we can be friends. I will leave the link to my Buy Me a Coffee account in the description box below. And I don't buy coffee. I buy craft supplies with the money from that Buy Me a Coffee account. But I can't wait to see you guys next time. And stay safe. God bless. Catch you on the next video. Thank you so much for watching. Special thank you to Corie for hosting this wonderful challenge. I look forward to it every month. And thank you so much for watching. Until next time, friends. Bye.